Welcome back. I'm Pastor Cat, and this is your weekly encouragement. So this week, I've been thinking about a couple of big things. Number one, specifically, the nature of Christ himself. What were his motivations as he walked the earth and spoke with people who needed to hear the gospel? And that really brought me to a very interesting passage, not exactly where I expected to be as I was preparing for this. We're going to be in John chapter 8 today, and the question of who is Jesus comes up. So let's jump in. So they were saying to him, "Who are you?" Jesus said to them, "What have I been saying to you from the beginning? I have many things to speak and to judge concerning you, but who sent me is true, and the things which I've heard from him, these I speak to the world." I want to stop there for just a second. I love that. So often people say that Christ's message about himself or how we see Christ has changed over time. Here in John 8, he says, "No, I've been saying the same thing since the very beginning. The real truth is the person who sent me." Now, at this point, they weren't quite sure who that was or exactly what he means. And John explains it just a little bit over here in verse 27. He says this: "They did not realize that he had been speaking to them about the Father. So Jesus said, 'When you lift up the Son of Man, you will know that I am he. And I do nothing on my own initiative, but I speak these things as the Father taught me. And he who sent me is with me. And he has not left me alone. For I always do the things that are pleasing to him.' As he spoke these things, many came to believe in him." I find it fascinating that in this passage, Christ says that the one who sent him is the author of all truth. Not only is he the author of all truth, but he doesn't do anything outside of what the Father has asked him to do. That's one of those questions I feel like I have to ask myself all the time. Am I really doing what God would have me do, or am I making decisions based on the things that I want, the way that I desire, the things that I feel? He actually expounds on this at the end of the passage, where he's going to talk a little bit about truth and even free will. I find it fascinating and enlightening for our lives. Let's finish it up. 31 through 32 says this: "So Jesus was saying to the Jews who had believed him, 'If you continue in my word, then you are truly disciples of mine, and you will know the truth, and the truth will make you free.'" There's a couple things that we can glean from this in our daily lives today. Number one, if we continue in what we know, what we've actually learned from the Bible, what the Holy Spirit has taught us, we are truly disciples. We don't have to be perfect today. We just have to be on that path to not only believe, but follow through with all the things we actually understand. In a lot of ways, this sounds like it would tie us up and put us in prison. Christ says exactly the opposite. Doing those things is going to give you true freedom, will actually set you free. I don't know about you, but that's hugely encouraging that not only does God bless us for doing what he called us to do, but he actually took the time to write it down, hand it down through history to us so that we can be truly free. Well, I hope this has been as encouraging to you as it has been to me. If you have any questions, comments, concerns, if you'd like to talk about how following the Word of God sets you free, put it in the comments down below. I'd love to hear about it. Don't forget to hit that like and that subscribe. I'll see you right back here next week. Be encouraged.